Hello, sports fans. Welcome to Red Bull Sri Lanka's Mind Behind, where we go behind the scenes to meet the man and, of course, meet the mind behind the man to figure out those key aspects that contribute to making some of the most elite sportsmen in the world. And today, joining us, of course, is Sri Lanka cricket's wicketkeeper, batsman, and current T20 vice captain, and not forgetting Red Bull athlete, Niroshan Digbala. Hello, Niroshan.
Hi.
How are you? And welcome aboard the show.
Thank you so much. I'm good. I'm all good these days.
Great.
No cricket.
Right. Yes. Yeah. Yes. So, how's everything looking right now for Sri Lanka cricket? Just before we get into the aspects that we talked about, how's things right now?
At the moment, we are planning to start training on the 1st of June.
Right.
For a couple of players who need rehab and more training. If you get a fast bowler, he need more training. So
they're
going to start those players first, and then in the middle of the month, they'll be starting with the batsmen.
Right. Okay, so like I told our fans who are watching right now, this is all about you, and it's all about getting to know you and getting to know some of the things that helped you become the sportsman that you are today. Okay? So we're going to turn the pages back in history to when you were a schoolboy.
Yeah.
What was, I mean, every sportsman becomes a sportsman because of a certain passion within them. Where did your passion for cricket begin? And do you remember your first stages of that passion?
Actually, I used to play cricket with my father inside the house and backyard cricket with my friends when I was really small. So then my classmate used to go to a cricket academy called Kent Cricket.
Right.
At the police ground in Kandy. So my best friend, he used to go on Sunday. So I told my father I want to go as well, just to play cricket for fun. So then I realized that this is just not only fun, this is more, something more for me. Then I realized, and at the age of 9, 10, I got into the cricket team, in my house cricket team.
Right.
So then I captained the house team.
This was your school house at Trinity College, Kandy, right?
Campbell House.
Right.
So I won the tournament when I was captaining, when I was like great. I was 10 at that moment. Then I went for training, under 13 cricket training, and then I got a place, a proper place. Then I realized there's something more that I could do for my college.
Right.
So then that's how I started playing cricket. Basically, my father was the man behind me when I started.
Wow, that's great news. Right, so just like we were talking about your passion, there are, as children, as schoolboy cricketers or aspiring sportsmen, there are idols that we look to. There are star cricketers that inspire us to become like them. Who were a couple of those figures for you as a child looking up into international cricket? Who drove you?
Firstly, mainly Kumar Sangakkara, because he was trained in, and he is a left-hander, and he's a wicket keeper. So my role model was Kumar Sangakkara, and I had number 11 on my jersey when I was playing in school. So, but unfortunately I had to change it for a 48, because I had to play with him. So no,
right,
we can't
right.
have the same number. So mainly Kumar Sangakkara, and I loved watching Brendan McCullum and Adam Gilchrist play. So because they are also wicket keepers and left-hand batsmen.
Right,
mainly.
Right, great. So Kumar Sangakkara, number 11. And how did that feel actually after using the number since you were a schoolboy, and when you finally came to playing on the same team with him? What was that feeling like?
Firstly, I had to play with him at NCC.
Right.
So he was playing for NCC. I joined NCC. So then I had to change the number. But firstly, I played with him, and before playing international cricket, I played with him in the club. So we both scored 200s. Had a 200 plus partnership with him for the first time. The first day I met him at a dressing room. I have met him outside cricket, but at first day we both scored 100s, and it was a good, brilliant game. And he had more pressure than me. He was like, I never seen someone like that. So in the dressing room, nervous. I went to him and I asked, why are you so nervous? You have played so many international matches, and why are you so nervous in this club game, just a club game? He said, I'm playing this as my last game in my career. So I'm nervous to perform. I want to dominate. So that's why I'm this nervous, he said.
Right, great. So let's go back to the point where you stepped into Sri Lanka cricket. What was your stepping stone? What helped you? I heard that you were, of course, schoolboy cricketer of the year in 2012. Yeah. And also you were a part of the Red Bull campus cricket, the international campus cricket campaign as well. So tell us a bit about that. And was that what really helped you to get into international cricket? What was that all about?
Yeah, in 2012, I became the schoolboy cricketer. That was a big moment in my life.
Right, of course.
And that helped me to go for the Under-19 Cricket World Cup. It was in Australia. So I performed in that as well. So then I became the schoolboy cricketer. Then I joined NCC.
Right.
Then I, luckily, I scored 5 centuries in that season.
Wow.
Then I got into the A team.
Right.
Then I toured to West Indies for the first time with an A team tour. A team.
Right.
So then, in that also, luckily that year was a great year, 2012-13, both the years. So then I was in England with the A team again.
Wow.
I didn't even know there was a game, national game at Galle. I didn't even know. I knew, but it was not in my mind.
Right.
Then suddenly a chairman selector called our manager and asked them to send me back to Sri Lanka. And I thought I'm a mischievous guy, so I asked them whether I did something
wrong. Yeah.
Yeah, he was like, then you have to go back and play the test match. I was like, what? Test match? Which test match?
Right.
I didn't even know what's happening in Sri Lanka because I was focused on the A-team tour in England. So then that's how I came to Sri Lanka and played the test match. So then...
this is when you were 21 years old. This was your test match, test cricket debut.
Yeah.
Right,
that's
great.
How I played the debut. And then after a few years, I joined BMS. So then I captained the BMS team and won the local university. Red Bull hosted the tournament and I won that game.
Red Bull campus cricket.
World. Right. So then we went to the World Finals, hosted in Sri Lanka.
Right.
And then we won the World Finals in 2017. That was a big moment. And there were so many international players like Lungingiri, KL Rahul played for India. I played for Sri Lanka. So then that was a big step for me.
Right, right.
To get into the... I was in the national team, but I was not in the team at that moment.
Right.
I played, but right. I was stopped.
Right.
So this moment, then again, selectors and everyone realized that I'm in the scene again, I'm performing, I'm scoring runs, I'm keeping my wicket trail.
Right.
So that was a big moment as well. In 2017, then I got into the national team again and then started performing again.
Right. Wow. So you've come a long way since then, making it from your first test debut and whatnot since you were 21 and even younger. You've come a long way and now it's a momentous time in your life. You are the vice captain of the Sri Lanka T20 team. What does it feel like in your position right now to be you? And what is your goal and what's your view for the team and the future of Sri Lanka cricket? I mean, possibly even a future captain of Sri Lanka cricket. I mean, already a vice captain. Tell us, what's your viewpoint about the team? What do you want for them? What's your goal as a vice captain?
I got the vice captaincy in 2019.
Right.
So then I was in New Zealand. Then so this is responsibility.
Yes. Sir.
So I was just a player when I was playing. I'm just a player. When I have a responsibility, I have to work hard and get the team together, get along with the captain well and the coaches as well. So then I had to go for the meetings and then I realized, but I have done it before, but I don't know how to handle all the players. It was in college.
Right.
I know everyone's together and we always be together.
Yep.
This is like players coming out and coming in,
yep,
and getting dropped.
Right.
New player comes in, I have to handle him as well. Yeah, so...
They're studying the personalities and stuff as a vice captain, right?
Yeah. So it's a responsibility. So I think I handle it well,
right,
and everyone get along with me well. So our targets, there are some targets, very high, big targets, but with the captain, what we talk about, we take one by one, just enjoy the game,
yep.
Go to the middle and enjoy the game, do whatever we could, can do, and bring glory, bring honor to our country. That's the only main thing in our head, and just be normal. And I want to make a good culture in the team and the unity, like a family. So then right. We'll rise to a different level for sure.
Yep, yep. Every sportsman goes through challenges. They face downtime, they face things that bring them down. But I think the thing that makes a sportsman better than the rest is being able to get up from it and keep going. What were some of those moments for you when you felt you were back down or something beat you down, and some of the things that challenged you the most? Tell us a bit about that.
There was one incident that happened in 2016 that I was in the national team in the T20 squad, and there was the Asia Cup and the World Cup ahead. So I was playing T20 only that time.
Right.
So then selected the side, and I was in the squad for right. The Asia Cup. So they said that whoever goes on the Asia Cup will be going on the World Cup. So after the Asia Cup, there was only 2 days. We flew back,
right.
Change up, pack our stuff, and go for the World Cup. So then in the Asia Cup, I only played one game against Pakistan,
right.
And I didn't get a chance back, and I only kept wickets. So we came back after the Asia Cup, we lost the Asia Cup, and we came back. And after 2 days, we have to go to India for the World Cup. So then everyone heard that selection committee was changed. So there are new selectors. So they suddenly in the morning, I'm packing my stuff, getting ready to go in the World Cup in the evening.
Right.
Flight was at night.
Right.
So then suddenly got a call, and a selector told me that you're not going in the World Cup. Not only me, there was another person actually, another player.
Right.
It was Jeffrey Vandersey, I guess. If I'm correct, yeah.
Right.
Jeffrey Vandersey. So both the players are not going in the World Cup.
Very demotivated,
yeah.
Of course, to hear that. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, so I was like, what? I didn't get a chance to bat in the Asia Cup. Or then they said that the Asian Cup squad will be going in the World Cup. And suddenly, I got a call, and when I was packing my stuff, they said, you're not going in the World Cup.
Right.
I was like, what? Now, that moment, I felt like it's a shame, actually. So I didn't know what to say to my parents, to my friends, and suddenly on news, it goes like, Dikwale and Vanessa is not going on the tour, and
right.
So many questions, so many media questions, and
very demotivating.
Yeah,
obviously.
And
yes.
Then I didn't know how to answer people. I didn't know how to face anyone.
Yep.
I didn't
yep.
know how to what to say. They are asking me, why aren't you going on the work? I said, I don't know.
Yep.
That can't happen. You have to know why.
Yep.
And then they thought that you must have done something wrong,
yep.
Or some mischievous thing, or like some unwanted stuff.
Yeah.
So then that was a day I felt
that
like
that was a huge challenge too.
Yeah, too. It was there for me for more than a month, but it motivates me and.
Right, and look at you now.
Yeah.
You've beaten that challenge and you've come a great distance since
yeah.
then.
That challenge motivated me.
Yes, of course.
To become this person, actually.
That's great.
Yeah.
I think every sportsman needs some of those as well,
yeah.
You know, something to bring you down. But the thing that makes a better sportsman is when you are ready to get back up,
yeah.
And hit them harder. And look at you now,
yeah.
Okay, where you've come now. So that's a great, great factor. Okay, so what drives you? Everybody needs that aspect to pick them up and push them to become something better, to try even harder every time they're knocked down. That's something that is necessary. What drives you? What helps you pick yourself up? Is it your family? Do you look to them for motivation? Or is it your boys in the team? What do you look at? What do you need to drive you?
Actually, that in my heart, I need, if I feel like I need something, I'll somehow get it.
Right. The determination.
That, yes,
right.
Determination. And always parents wanted me to play for Sri Lanka, but I never wanted to play for Sri Lanka. I just wanted to be a professional cricketer.
Right.
I didn't think that I would play this earlier when I was 21. So that helped me a bit, and now I'm driving my cricketing life because I want to bring glory and honor, and what we lost, I have to gain that back, of course. I have to gain it for our country. And the targets, there are huge targets, goals. So I'm driving now for a target that which is 2023 World Cup.
Right.
If I get a chance to captain or be in the team, I want to win the game.
Yep.
Games, and I want to win the World Cup. That's my target, 2023 World Cup. That's how I'm driving.
We wish you all the best, everyone. Thank at you, Red sir. Bull, and of course Red Bull is behind you. Yeah. Officially as well.
Yeah.
They're with you all the way. Yeah. And like you said, we wish you all the best to bring that glory and that honor that you want, as well as the country wants, back to the country as well.
Thank you.
Great. So how do you prepare for an upcoming game? I think the build-up to a game, any sportsman faces it, regardless of cricket, rugby, regardless of what it is, that long wait in the dressing room until you get on the field, until it's your time to swing a bat or whatever. How do you prepare for it? How do you motivate yourself to get out there and do your best?
Actually, I don't think much.
Right.
I just go there and play for my instincts.
Right.
So when I wait in the dressing room, I don't watch the game.
Right.
I know if it's a test match, I know I'm batting at number 7, 5 right. down. So there are so I'll go sleep, have a nap.
Right.
If I keep wickets for more than a day or something, more than 100 overs,
right.
I'll go have a nap if I feel sleepy, or I'll just listen to music.
Right.
Or just have a random chat with someone, or talk with someone. Do some funny things make everyone smile. So I want to be happy.
Right.
If I think much too much, I'm not going to perform. I know that.
Yep, that's true.
So I want to be relaxed in the dressing room. I just even don't watch the game.
Right.
I watch it in the television. And when I get my chance, if it's like in South Africa, New Zealand, Australia, I have to go out and get used to the weather.
Yep.
If it's really cold, I have to go out. And in Sri Lanka, I don't even watch. I just be me, normal,
right?
Just relax.
Until you're supposed to go and get it going. Right. How do you deal with pressure? Now, you just told me, like, in the dressing rooms, that is definitely a major part of the pressure. A lot of people put themselves through a lot of unnecessary pressure, like you said, if they are too focused on the game, if they're worried about it. But another aspect of pressure is when you get on the field, when you're faced with an intimidating score, a big score, or any intimidating bowler, for that matter. How do you deal with pressure in those aspects?
I say pressure is in your mind.
Yes,
that's in your mind. That's what you build.
Yep.
If you see, if someone comes to you and say, pressure, that gets into your mind and it'll be in your mind forever. At that point, when I go into the middle, I don't feel anything. I don't hear anything most of the time.
Right.
So that means I'm calm and not nervous. I'm relaxed. So pressure means like I feel pressure when I'm keeping wickets mostly because.
Right.
Not when I'm batting. Keeping wickets is a major responsibility, and I have to be focused every ball. Not like the other players. I have to expect that I'm getting this ball every single ball. So I feel a bit pressurized when I'm keeping wickets. But I know how to. When I talk,
right,
I have no pressure.
Right.
If I'm silent, I know I'm a bit nervous.
Right.
So. To get away with the pressure, I talk with someone that I cheer up everyone.
Right, so yes, of course, I think that is one of the most important factors of a wicketkeeper as well.
That's what I do.
Talking to the team, keeping them going.
So then I'm more focused, no pressure.
Right.
That's how I do it.
That's great.
Yeah.
Wow, that's great. Okay, so what's your most unforgettable? Now, you have so many years of cricket, like I said, since you were a schoolboy, different aspects of it, and sometimes some of our most memorable moments are schoolboy cricket as well. You've had so many years of cricket already. Tell us a couple of those unforgettable moments since you were Trinitian and then since you moved into NCC and then into Red Bull cricket and of course into national cricket. Tell us a bit about those. Some of your most favorite and unforgettable moments.
Yeah, I have a few. First one is being the schoolboy cricketer.
Right. Yes.
Before that, I won the big match after 26 years. Trinitian and then this big match. Last we won in 1986. In 2012 we won that, and that was after 26 years.
Yeah, huge achievement.
Yeah,
right?
I was the captain. So then, and the other one, apart from international cricket,
right.
Being the Red Bull Campus World Finals.
Right.
That's the World Cup.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, so winning that is an unforgettable moment. And if it's international cricket, playing my debut with Mahal Jayawardene, Kumar Sangakkara, Angelo Mathews, Rangan Hera, those players, that is a dream. I used to watch them play, but I never thought that I would be able to play with Kumar Sangakkara and Mahal Jayawardene. And I had a partnership with Team Mahal, over 100 runs in that game, so that was an unforgettable moment. Best moment in my life was being the man of the match and being the man of the series in South Africa. First time we won a T20 series in South Africa. So in that game, I was the man of the match and the man of the series. So those are the memories.
Well, so far, but I'm guessing you'll be having a lot more great memories in the future as well, Niroshan.
Yeah.
And hopefully that World Cup in 2023.
Yeah.
Right, great. So just before we wrap things up, we've got a lot of sports fans watching us, aspiring sportsmen, schoolboy cricketers who are probably looking at you the way you looked at Sangakkara back when you were a schoolboy cricketer, looking up at you and hoping to be like you and maybe even play it next to you. And what's your message out to them? Even if they're a cricketer or not, if they're a sportsman, what would you, what's the advice that you would give them to help them push through the challenges and become something greater in the future?
Yep, I just take day by day, that moment by moment. So just enjoy that moment. Whatever you do in your life, just enjoy that. Be happy in that moment. And work hard, then you learn. You have to have the passion. If you are having a target or a goal, you have to have the passion that I'm going to get this. That and the motivation. Self-motivation is the main thing. So I think just enjoy your life and be you. Don't change yourself for anyone or for anything. So be you and have the passion and that need you, the feel that you need this. So then you go for that target.
That's great. Yeah, that's great. So thank you very much, Niroshan. Ladies and gentlemen, Niroshan Digwala, like I mentioned, he's the current T20 vice captain, and definitely a long way for him to go. And a big thank you from everyone here at Red Bull for being a part of Red Bull and for joining us today as well to give us a peek into the mind behind the man right here.
Thank you so much.
We wish you all the best for your future, Niroshan.
Thank you.
And keep going. And that wraps up our edition with Mind Behind, of course, with Niroshan Digwala. And we'd like to ask you to stay tuned and catch us next time. Stay safe, sports fans.